Hello and welcome to another quick special effects episode from Film Station 3000. Today we'll be teaching you how to do a bullet wound. Let's get started. By the end of this tutorial, I want to look dead. So I start by applying foundation a few shades lighter to get a pale complexion. I set the foundation with face powder, also a shade lighter than what I normally would use. Brush a small amount of spirit gum to where you want to have the wound, in my case my forehead. Wait for it to become tacky. Roll a small amount of scar wax into a ball using the palms of your hands. Next, apply it onto the spirit gum. Smooth the edges onto your skin using your fingers. If it gets too sticky, rubbing a small amount of lotion on your fingertips will make it more manageable. With the back smooth side of the nail clippers, flatten and remove the excess. I coated the inside of a paintbrush with lotion so it won't stick to the scar wax. With the inside of the paintbrush or a pen, create a hole right in the middle of the wax and smooth it out with your fingers, going inside the wound and opening it more. I gently go over my forehead and the wound with a soft makeup sponge and the face powder to blend the rest of my face to the wound. Okay, now it's time to make the wound look real. Using some black face paint and a small brush, color the bottom inside of the bullet hole. Use red face paint around the wound's inside and then blend it with the black. Apply gel blood on the inside for more realistic coloring and texture. Using my Ben Nye Bruise Wheel, I blend yellow, red, and maroon color all around my forehead to create bruising from the impact. Last but not least, I fill the wounds with as much stage blood as I can and kind of let it drip on its own. I also lightly brush some stage blood around the wound. This will assure that the wound's coloring looks realistic. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and like.